What happened to my kitchen? Morning.
So, now that you have the profile. Yeah. The profile. Now to do the bevel and the ricasso line. That's fancy. Yeah, continue on with the slightly buzzed knife making. Because I am working with power tools, people. I want 10. I really need to do something about this hair. This is probably a good idea. Okay. We'll just stick with Untamed Lion. I am, however, keeping the shirt because My Little Pony and knives
are like that. This is gonna be a lot of rasping. And see that little line? It's where the edge starts. That's the ricasso line. So, and actually, it's gonna be higher than this. And make sure to do it on both sides. You know, Tom, this is actually a very weird shape. But you wanted it. Now it's time to light it on fire. I have a three-legged cat. That has nothing to do with me making knives. No, really. She was that way when I got her. I swear. I'm lying in metal filings. Ugh. Ah! The backyard forge. First, conveniently hide from your neighbors, because you live downtown. Your neighbors think you're weird enough. Backyard forge. The hair dryer attached to a tube blows air up underneath a bowl with holes. Regular briquettes. Like a barbecuing man. Safety goggles. The gloves. The guest of honor, Mr. Knafe. Kids, do not do this at home. For some reason you do. Safety. In case I light myself on fire. Or anything else. You also need a magnet. Boop, boop. Because when a knife is glowing orange at 1500 degrees Fahrenheit, it will no longer be magnetic. That's when you stick it in oil. You grab yourself a beer. Kids, do not ever do this. I am a professional. No, I'm not. Now you forge a knife. Fire in the hole. Safety always. Magnet. You might get a temperature bond and like it'll boil up around it and not cool right, so you want to swirl it so it's constantly in contact with the oil. What just happened is uneven hardening, uneven temperatures. You want the hardened part to have a real glassy sound. But on one side of the blade, a little bit more than the other. I heated it back up, threw it on a flat surface, kind of forged it, pounded it out, got it back straight. I got a little hammer mark in it though. 01 tool steel is very forgiving in the fact that I can stick it back into the forge now, reheat it, get it glowing hot, quench it, and it could turn out okay, maybe. For now, I'm gonna at least try to salvage it, and then I'll talk to Charlie, my mentor, and ask his advice. But it's not a lost cause yet.
Hardening makes it really brittle. You get it as hard as possible, and then temper it, which is softening it back up so that you can sharpen it and actually do stuff with it. But obviously, at the beginning, it's way too soft, and you can cut it with a hacksaw. So harden, temper, and we'll see. Maybe okay. This is straight.
Okay. Now we're gonna bake it like cookies, man. Yeah. $4.50 for an hour. Add chocolate chips, it's amazing.
I think it's a bust. It's not straight. It's got a hammer mark in it, and I think because it was real thick here and I went real thin with the bevel, and it just hardened and tempered unevenly. That's not right. This one has a lot thinner bevel in it. It's this, almost the same thickness all the way through. And it heated and cooled evenly, I guess. Don't worry, Tom. I can do this. We'll do it. I have to start over. Stay tuned. Yay.
Well, I hope you at least learn something about knife making, because I try to be educational. I'm definitely learning myself. I'm gonna try to figure out what I did wrong, and Tom, I'm making you a knife. The greatest thing about this whole experience is that from now on, every time you see, hear, or think anything about My Little Pony, you're gonna think about knives. That is awesome. So glad I could help. Maybe I need to sex it up more.
Yeah. Oh yeah.